inside a Limerick prison.
What's there to describe? Like, we signed in, and then when they knew I had a lift back, they let me out.
And what were the conditions like? Because Margarita D'Arcy, before she was inside, she said the conditions in Limerick were terrible, unbelievable. Did you see what
we were just in a holding cell, like we weren't actually in the main prison itself, so I didn't actually see anybody. The staff themselves were obviously incredibly professional and good at their job, so that's all there is to tell, really, you know.
What about the €2,000 fine? Will you still prepared to pay it, or are you still prepared not to pay it?
We made it abundantly clear we were never going to pay that fine, absolutely not. And actually, our resolve is even more hardened after our experiences today, when I suppose you're on the edge of thinking that you're going to be separated from your family at this time of year. It puts you very much in the shoes of those Syrian families who are separated permanently from their loved ones as a result of the horrendous war that's going on in their soils. And we are complicit in that by continuing to allow Shannon Airport to be used. So we're going to do whatever we can to use our Dáil positions and any other platform we have to continue to champion on those issues.
Were you expecting to be brought to Limerick Prison today?
No,
daily?
Absolutely not.
So what
no
happened?
Idea whatsoever.
Did you arrive by arrangement, or what happened today?
I had, obviously McWallace had been arrested this morning. We had no idea of that when we found out about that. I was in contact with Swords Garda Station. They allowed me time to talk to my daughter and wait for her to come home from school. So I arranged to go and present myself later on this evening. So.
What do you think of the situation where you were court ordered to pay a €2,000 fine? You declined to do it, which meant you were sent to jail. You were supposed to spend 30 days in jail, yet you're only able to spend less than 2 hours. What do you think of the whole court system?
Sure, it's utter lunacy. I mean, we're on the Dáil record already as saying the whole system of courts fines is completely unworkable. It's a waste of Garda resources. It's a waste of prison staff resources. And this government has sat on its hands in terms of bringing in a serious alternative, which has nothing got to do with us today. It's a far bigger problem than that, and I suppose it does put the spotlight on the urgency of the need to address that, and we've articulated that and are on the record on it for all issues, nothing to do with us per se, you know.
Your colleague,
do you feel as a public representative that you have wasted Garda resources today, the money that has been spent on bringing you down here?
Absolutely not. I mean, the gas thing is, I heard people commenting earlier on, did they think that we as lawmakers should be breaking the law? I've never heard the likes of Leo Varadkar talk about the illegality being engaged in by this state and breaching our neutrality. And we think we've a responsibility under the Nuremberg principles when we see an injustice being done. Not only do we actually have a legal obligation to speak out, we have a legal right, we have an obligation to speak out against that. And that's what we've tried to do along with other activists in Shannon Watch in relation to the ongoing use of Shannon by the US military. And we're going to keep doing that, obviously, particularly now. I mean, the issues are more relevant now than when we tried to search the plane 18 months ago, when you see the airstrikes and the slaughter that's currently underway in Syria.
Would you breach security again at Shannon?
Absolutely, if necessary. Absolutely, yeah, completely. This Irish government has to wake up to what's going on. We are complicit in the slaughter of innocent people, probably people who are murdered today. And it's got to stop. We have produced, at our court case, we produced evidence which showed categorically our neutrality was being breached and weapons and armoury were being transported through Shannon. The judge accepted that information and the expertise of our witnesses without qualification, but said that basically it was because of the arrangement he had to find against us. But that bigger picture still arises, and I think the majority of Irish people agree with us. We've seen that in successive opinion polls in relation to neutrality.
You're on temporary release now.
Yeah.
So do you still have the rest of the 30-day sentence hanging over you, and are you concerned that you might indeed be back here for Christmas?
I'm not. But your interpretation is correct, but no, I don't think so. I think we can live with the conditions, I would imagine, yeah.
And what are the conditions?
Oh, I don't know. They just read them out to me there now. I have to live in my house and stuff like that, so I had every intention of living out there and that kind of thing.
Do you think, Deputy Daly, it makes a farce of the whole judicial system, though, that somebody goes through the court process, gets charged, convicted, a fine is issued in lieu of a time in jail, the fine isn't paid, and then you don't serve any time in jail?
Utterly. I mean, sure, we're on the record on that one anyway, you know, as I say, in terms of all non-payment of fines, and it's served to put the spotlight on that. So maybe the government will get the finger out on this issue, because It's long overdue, and should we all know that? Like, they've been talking about this for long enough. I mean, it's an embarrassment for the guards and the prison staff to have to do this, you know?
I think
the special thing is that, you know, it will be shocking for citizens out there to realise that the reason why is that there was no extra treatment. This is normal. Like, we were surprised. Like, we fully expected to serve time. We're obviously absolutely delighted that we're not, but that's the system.
And do you feel in any way embarrassed by the process?
We're not.
Yourself?
I feel utterly embarrassed that Ireland is complicit in the slaughter of innocent people, and it's my obligation as a legislator to do everything I can to prevent that. We have sought to do it, myself and Deputy Wallace, 5 years in Parliament, putting down questions to ministers, giving them information about breaches of our neutrality, being told by them, go and get us the information and the evidence. When we seek the evidence, they don't do anything about it. We presented that evidence in our court case. They haven't acted upon that. They've completely refused to search military aircraft despite repeated evidence that's there. No, we're not going to give up, and the activists in Shannon Watch aren't going to give up. We owe it to Irish people and to people around the world and in the Middle East on this. It's an absolute disgrace. That's what I'm embarrassed about, is the conduct of this government 100%.
Are you going back to Dublin now?
I am.
And do you think that this will hinder your re-election chances in the upcoming general election?
I don't, but that's a matter for the people of Dublin North, and they'll judge my Dáil term accordingly anyway, with or without this, but I wouldn't think so. But if it does, it does.
Thanks for
talking.